Solemn gathering is a testimony of this. People close to you, people you have met and worked with, and today they share with you the joy of this blessing of service and ministry. Because at one point in their lives you have touched them. They have come to pray for you and wish you well, because they know you are embracing a greater responsibility and you offer yourself to the service of many others, especially for those who are in need and at the margins. And today, we are assembled not merely as friends, but as a church, a people of God. Today, we rejoice, for the Lord continues to send shepherds. From the book of Jeremiah, we are assured, I will give you shepherds after my own heart. In these words of the prophet Jeremiah, God promises his people that he will never leave them without shepherds. To gather them together and guide them, I will set shepherds over them who will care for them, and they shall fear no more nor be dismayed. In my younger years, I have been inspired by the piece entitled The World Needs Men and Women. The world needs men and women who cannot be bought, whose word is their bond, who put character above wealth, who possess opinions in the will, who are larger than their vocations, who do not hesitate to take chances, who do not lose their individuality in the crowd, who will be as honest in small things as in great things, who will make no compromise with wrong, whose ambitions are not confined to their own selfish desires, who will not say they do it because everybody else does it, who are true to their friends through good report and evil report, in adversity as well as in prosperity, who do not believe that shrewdness, cunning, and hard-headedness are the best qualities for gaining success, who are not ashamed or afraid to stand for the truth when it is unpopular, who can say no with emphasis although the rest of the world says yes. I am still inspired by these words, and I'm sure many of you are. But why do we feel that this has become a heavy standard? Why do we feel there seems to be this diversity of this type of men and women, either in church and in society? Bishop Moody, we cannot say exactly and perfectly that these qualities are our own, but may be a reminder that today, you, we are receiving something greater than ourselves. And again, this grace of service as bishop is not something we merited or are entitled to. It is a gratuitous gift from God. In our weakness, there is the strength of God. We need such men and women in our family, in our community, in our neighborhoods, in our institutions, in government, in church, in civil society. Who has not needed us, yet it is not created us. The Son Jesus Christ, who humbled himself